One of the great challenges of this century is building a computer from first principles in physics. Now, at the smaller scales, physics is about quantum theory, so no wonder that worldwide there's a big race going on to build quantum computers. Now, this week, the group of Menno Veldhorst at QuTech in Delft is publishing in Nature a different approach to quantum computing. We're here at the teaching lab of Delft University to talk about these exciting new developments with group leaders Menno Veldhorst, Giordano, Scappucci, and PhD candidate Nico Hendrickx. So Menno, first of all, what is your vision on quantum computers?
Let me start with what I believe is the greatest technological achievement of mankind. And that's the transistor that enabled today's information age. We can put billions of transistors on a chip and we're using it day in, day out. Now imagine that that technology can be used to build quantum technology. And what we've published in Nature is a demonstration that we can use that technology to build 4 qubits to function as a quantum processor.
So you're trying to build a quantum computer with the building blocks of a normal computer. Giordano, how do you start out there?
So quantum bits are pretty fragile. So we need to engineer the materials in order to preserve the quantum information that we store in the quantum bits. At the same time, we want to build a functionality to control these qubits. And so what we do is we engineer quantum-grade materials.
And quantum-grade materials would be what?
It turns out that a good starting point is using germanium. This is the material that was used for the first transistor, but we cannot just use germanium as is. We need to engineer it to become quantum grade. So what we do is we squeeze germanium and we put it inside a material made out of silicon and germanium, all integrated on a silicon wafer. And the nice thing is that we use exactly the same technology that is used in the microelectronic industry.
So germanium seems to be a good starting point, but how do you actually produce a qubit in germanium then?
Let me start first with the transistor again. So in a transistor, an enormous number of electrons are flowing from one side to the other. What we've done is basically pausing this current flow of electrons to really capture a single electron. And we put it into a box which you call a quantum dot. Now each quantum dot can hold a single electron, and each electron can then be used as a qubit. Now to be precise, we actually don't make use of electrons. In germanium, we're making use of holes. These are the absence of electrons. And it turns out that holes have really unique properties for quantum information.
So, Nico, you were one of the researchers that did the actual experiments. What are the developments?
Well, when I started my PhD about 4 years ago in the group of Menno, Giordano was just able to grow the germanium. And we were excited to start working with it. And already soon, we were able to make the first quantum dot. And from there on, it went really fast. We've been able to double our qubit count every year. First one, then two, and now 4. And not only this, we've also managed to position these qubits in a 2x2 array. And you could consider this a crucial step towards practical quantum applications.
And why would it be important to put these qubits on a grid?
Well, if you think about the future quantum computer, it will most likely require millions or even billions of qubits to work properly. And these are numbers that you can only achieve by putting the qubits on a two-dimensional grid. And not only this, in order to do accurate calculations, we also need something which we call quantum error correction. And this requires qubits to be coupled along two directions. And of course, we only show the 4-qubit processor here, but using that processor, we can really show that we can couple the qubits in two directions and that we can actually move quantum information around this array.
So Menno, we just heard from Nico that the qubit count is doubling every year. So what's up for next year?
Well, let me be honest, the developments we've made every year have been really surprising me every time. Moore's law has been a fantastic predictor in classical technology. And if we could keep following that with quantum technology, that would be truly unique. Of course, we have many ideas on how to do it. We're working hard on it. But it's also a time that industry can start to contribute to the research itself, but also start to profit from it.
Worldwide, many companies are involved in developing quantum technology. So what is the status of germanium in quantum technology?
Germanium has been largely been overlooked in the last few years, and our results have really come as a big surprise. We now see efforts on germanium starting almost everywhere. Fortunately, at QuTech, we are really in the lead on the scientific research and we have a unique amount of expertise. Indeed, the future is looking bright.
So, Menno, that sounds really promising. I'm looking forward to the future. Thank you, guys, and good luck.